أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، صلاة طيبة مباركة بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, we do this video by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to expose the event that it's happening in East Midlands Mosque according to the ruqya of our brother in Islam, Abdul Ra'uf ibn Halima, who is from Tunisia, like myself. Muslims first, but he's from Tunisia, like myself. We do this video to explain some serious matter that is happening in that event and why it is not right to go to this event and listen from brother Abdul Ra'uf. Because basically, first of all, we agree that for the Raqi to be upon the correct manhaj of the Raqi, he should be in the correct aqidah. First of all, and this is the haqq, and the haqq is haqq, our brother Abdul Ra'uf, he's in the aqidah of Ahlul Sufiyya, the aqidah of the Sufism. And we know that they have got the wrong aqidah, and it's the wrong aqidah, not the same than Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And the other issue is the fact that the method of our brother Abdul Ra'uf, it is wrong. Why? Because if you watch most of his videos, you will see the fact that there is always a third person between him and the patient who comes for treatment. Means brother Abdul Ra'uf, he will catch and he will bring the third person, and that third person will catch the jinn inside of the body, so brother Abdul Ra'uf will punish this jinni and deal with him inside of the third person body. Means attract it from the patient, attract the jinni from the patient, hold an prisoner in the third person body, and then deal with the jinni in that way. We have a big problem with his methodology, with his way of doing the ruqya. First of all, let's see our proof and that our hujjah is the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa ashabi ijma'in, and that's an Abi Hurayrah radiallahu anhu. Abu Hurayrah, may Allah be pleased with him, he reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one day I was praying and an afreed from the jinn came close to me to disturb me from the salat, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the power, yeah, to get hold of this jinni, of this afreed, to get hold of him as he came close to disturb Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam salat. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and I got hold of his neck to the extent that I can feel the coldness of his saliva on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thumb. And Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa sallam said, and I was gonna tie this jinni, this afreed from the jinn, in one pillars of the mosque, so the children will throw stone at him and we'll throw a stone at him, and the people will see what's happened. But then Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam said, and I haven't done so. And he alayhi salatu wasalam never got hold of this jinni and tie him in the pillar of the mosque. Why? He says, because I remembered the dua of my brother Sulaiman alayhi salam, the Prophet of Allah, who Allah gave him the power over the jinn. Yeah? And why? Because this is the verse in the Quran, because Sulaiman alayhi salam said, after A'udhu billahi minashaitanir rajim, Rabbi ighfir li wa hab li mulkan la yanbaghi li ahadin min ba'di. Sulaiman alayhi salam said, oh Allah, give me a kingdom and a power that you never gave it to anybody before me and nobody after me. And Allah gave him the power over the jinn, and we know that they worked for Sulaiman alayhi salam. So if Muhammad alayhi salatu was salam never imprisoned the jinni, tied him in that pillar to punish him, the afrit of the jinn, who is Abdul Ra'uf ibn Halima to imprison the jinni inside of the third person who used to be ex-patient, that third person possessed by jinn, to punish the jinni inside of that body? That's not the correct ruqya according to the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. That's why we have an issue with it. And that's why it's very dangerous to go and learn the ruqya from this Muslim. Why? Because we have explained to you, if Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, never imprisoned a jinni who is this Muslim to say I can imprison a jinni inside of a body and then deal with him like this. That's wrong. So that's why, dear brothers and sisters, this video is to expose this Raqi and the whole event. And no wonder why the mosque, which is going to be held in East London Masjid. And what do you expect from a mosque like this? When this mosque itself hold meeting with the enemies of Islam, hold meeting with the enemy of the Islam inside to spy upon the Muslims who call for La ilaha illallah Muhammad al-Rasulullah. What do you expect more than that? أقول وقولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always show the haqq. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open your hearts to the truth that I have said. Stay away from his methodology of ruqya. He is upon the aqidah of Ahlul Sufiyyah, not of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. You might see in front of your eyes that it's working, but it's not the correct manhaj. And Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.